What's up everyone, welcome back to the technology series of my channel. So we are back doing the WordPress tutorials. This is the sixth episode that we are shooting for you. Why am I here on YouTube? To share knowledge. Basically, my knowledge should be shared with the entire world. Your knowledge should also be shared with the entire world. So make sure that you start your own YouTube channel and start sharing whatever knowledge you have with you. Sharing knowledge is the best powerful tool that humans have right now. So let's give at least, you know, this much to the community. Alright. So what are we going to do in this sixth tutorial? We are going to make two sections on the homepage. We had in the previous tutorial, we created the first section, the first fold of the website. Now we are going to create the second fold of the website. In the second fold of the website, we are going to create a carousel. Now a carousel is very, you know, good looking on the website because it contains a lot of elements which can be fitted in one area. Now with the carousel, we are also going to create different tabs. So again, different tabs will accommodate more and more content which can be shown in one single section. So this is the left section that we are going to study today. And the next section is the right hand section, that is going to be a completely purely text section that we are going to create. But the best part of the text section is that we are going to modify the text according to our needs, however we want. May it be the font size, the colors, everything related to font styling. There's a very beautiful plugin called Easy Google Fonts. Okay, Easy Google Fonts. So if you don't know how to use this plugin, this video is going to help you become a pro in that. Okay, so what else are we doing? The third section is about a little bit of animation that we are going to apply to the text right now. More and more animations, is available in WordPress, WP Bakery, Page Builder. But for now, simple animations on the text on the right hand side that we are going to create. So let's begin with the sixth tutorial. So this is the second fold of the website, the car review section, where we have the latest first drive, road test, and comparo, right? So this is like a section where there is a carousel. You can scroll using the left and the right arrow. There is one more functionality to it. When you click on first drive, you will see the section changes, but the element remains the same. That is, it remains as a carousel, but only the data inside the carousel changes. So similarly for road test and comparo. So we are going to try and replicate the same section on our website, that is the second fold below the first fold. So let's go ahead and make this section. So I'll go ahead and edit the same homepage that I had duplicated last time. I'm still going to use the backend editor of WP Bakery Page Builder. And let's create the section that we just saw, the carousel section. So I'll go at the bottom. Okay, now previously I showed you how to add a row from using this plus button on top. But let's scroll at the bottom and see how we can add it from here. Okay, so let me remove this. All right. So we can also click on the plus button at the bottom. Clicking on this will open the same window that we click on the plus button on top. Now, as we see on the overdrive.in, we have tabs over here. So these are called tabs, right? Latest, first drive, row test, comparo. Now we will first start with creating a tab, and then we will create the section, the carousel section, inside all the tabs that we'll create. Okay, let's go back. Search for tabs. It's as simple as this, tabs. Now you can add n number of tabs over here, but keep it limited always, because you don't want to confuse the user with, you know, which tab to go on. Or when it comes to mobile responsiveness, so many tabs will not look good on a mobile phone. All right, so this is the first tab, it's empty. This is the second tab, which is empty as well. We'll rename the first tab, and we'll rename the first tab to section 1. Section 1, Okay, so the good part is you can also add a icon with on the tab. So if you see here on OverDrive, before latest you can add a small icon if you want to give a nice beautiful icon to denote what it means, to denote what the word means, or something similar. So we are not going to add any icon over here right now. I will click on save. It will quickly reflect over here saying section 1. Let's click on tab 2. Rename the tab 2 to I clicked on the wrong button. I'll click on edit the pencil icon. I'll rename it to section 2. Okay, perfect. So now as we have renamed both the section, we will add one more section and name it as section 3. Let's limit the tabs to 3 tabs for now. We will go ahead and start adding data in the tab, that is a carousel. So again, clicking on the plus button. So you all will have to click the plus button 3 times. That is for section 1. Then again, click on section 2, click on the plus button to add the carousel, and again for section 3. So we are going to add this. We are going to start adding search types carousel. Okay. What we want to display is the blogs that is written on your website. We need to display all the blogs sliding in the carousel. So we will click on blog carousel. Now there are two options, simple, advanced. Simple means it has its own settings. It will directly start displaying the carousel as per the default settings. If you click on advanced, you will get a lot of options over here to configure how your carousel will start looking. Okay, so I'll select simple for now. Content below, I will select content inside image. So for two tabs, for two sections, section 1 I'll select content inside image, for section 2 I will click on content below image. All right. Except length, this means the description of the blog, okay, whatever you have written, can be shown over here, but I'll keep it as 0 because we want only the title and the image of the blog to be displayed here. Items per page I'll select as 5. Rest of the settings I'll keep it as is. There are a lot of options here, carousel options, top navigation with title, so we'll keep this as classic. For the next section we'll be adding one more carousel. Over there we'll select top navigation with title and text. Okay, we want navigation style, so we'll keep it as style 1. We want navigation color to be light. Okay, so let's not keep this option. You know what this means, right? Pause and hover. That means if you take your mouse inside the carousel section, it will stop scrolling automatically. Title, let's keep it as is. Extras, I will hide the author. I will hide the comments, likes, because it's a very small section and we do not want to display all this data over there. All categories. All right, let's click on save. Now the blog carousel is added in section 2. Once we go to section 2, it will again show us blank. That means we have to add one more carousel over here. So click on plus, type carousel. You can select blog carousel again. Let's click on advanced. As we said before, except length will be 0. All these settings will be the same. Let's go to navigation, carousel pagination. We do not, let's add carousel pagination and you will see how it looks. For that we'll need a lot of blogs, but we have limited blogs, so I don't know whether the pagination will appear over there. We'll have a look at that. Pause on hover. Let's take a look at this, how this works. Title, I will change the title to F5 so that it looks a bit small. Carousel background color, let it be black. Extras, we like the author. Date, comments, like, categories is all categories.
Alright, so we have added two carousels in two sections. We'll keep the third section empty and we'll take a look how this section looks. Let's refresh this page. Perfect. Now we have a section 1, section 2 and section 3. Section 3 is empty, we did not add anything. Section 2 has big images with title on it. Section 1 has small images and title on it. It also has a left and right navigation. Okay, but it's not very much visible over here. We'll see why. Alright, because my page was zoomed in. Okay. So we have successfully added a carousel. Okay, like we saw on overdrive.in. We'll go back to the home page. But you see the tabs over here is on the right hand side. So let's move the tabs to the right hand side of the page. Okay, we'll scroll down to the page again. We will edit the tabs. Okay. Did you follow this? We have to click on the pencil icon of edit tabs. Okay, we will make it right. Active section will be just one. Design options, you can adjust all the padding and borders over here and the margins. Text and style, let's keep it as H2. Let's make it a little big. Okay, we'll come back to the font family later. Let's update this. Go back to the home page, refresh the page, and you'll see the effects over here. The sections, the tabs were on the left hand side. Now we have moved it to the right hand side. And this is how it is behaving here. Okay, the difference here in the first section is you got a left arrow and a right arrow, correct? In section 2, you will see that the images are big. We do have a navigation available, but these are the dot navigation available. Okay, so you can adjust all these settings while you're adding a carousel on the page. Let's see how we can improve this section, the section 2. We'll reduce the image size a bit and make it look more better and similar to the first section 1. Let's go back. First, we will drag this entire section and bring it to the second fold of the website. So using the backend editor, you can drag using those cross arrows, take it at the top of the page and place it in the second fold of the website below the first fold that we had designed last time. Okay, so clicking on section 2, we can now click on edit section icon. We will close that. We will click on the edit block carousel option. Okay, we had clicked on advanced. Now, large screen stage padding. So, read the description here. Set left and right padding style and pixel onto the stage wrapper. Stage padding, we do not need that. Tablet landscape stage padding, we are not changing that. Tablet portrait stage padding, set left and right padding and style onto, we do not need that. Let's go back to the navigation. Carousel pagination, we need yes. Loop, we need a yes. We are hiding everything. Okay, let's see what change will make it look similar to the section 1 block carousel. Okay, large. I did a little research on how we can make the section 2 carousel similar to the section 1 carousel. But this is how the formatting and this is how the styling is done by default for this carousel. And I would say that for a basic starter demo, we should not go ahead and edit the existing default carousel, the different styles of carousel which are available. If you wanted to make it similar, the better way and the best way to do it right now is to replace this carousel, which I'm showing it to you right now. Replace this carousel with a, we had selected advanced before, replace it with a simple carousel. You can select content below the image, or you know, content inside the image, that is on your preference. Save it, update it, update the page, go to the demo page and refresh. So now you see the carousel is almost similar. The only difference is we have selected that the content should be inside the image, and for section 2 we have decided the contact should be below the image. So we will go ahead and remove the author, the date and the comment section from here. Quickly go ahead, section 2, edit the block carousel, extras, we hide the author, date, comments, likes, and the categories are hidden already. Categories will be all updated, and now refresh. Perfect. So now we have the same carousel section in two different designs or patterns. Now it depends on how you want to keep it on your website, based on the designing pattern that you want to follow. Section 3 is still empty. Let's see how we can use it, or even we or if we don't want to use it, we can just remove it from there and proceed to the next section of the demo. As we see on overdrive.in, in the second fold there are two sections. One is car reviews. On the right hand side you see most popular. So let's go ahead and create the most popular section. This time the most popular section we will create it in a manual way. Okay, we are not going to basically use any existing element. We will use a text element and we will create that section. You will get a taste of how to create or write your own text, and how to create an horizontal line, and how to put it, you know, one below the other. So let's go ahead and create that. First, if you remember from the first demo video, you know, in the first WP Bakery page builder tutorial, we learned how to create different sections. That is, there is a 12 column container, and how to divide the container into multiple sections or columns. Okay, so here we need two containers. We need 2x3 plus 1x3, so I'll select that. Okay, so now as soon as I selected, the first tab section automatically became a 2x3 section, and the next section, next column, is a 1x3 section. Let's go ahead and add what we want, and we want a normal text editor, that is text block. So if you read, a block of text with this editor, WYSIWYG editor, correct? So we need this because we are going to add some kind of HTML and some kind of modification, and it should reflect in the front end. So we'll select this. Okay, now if you see, this is a text editor. There is a lot of options over here. We have what kind of heading, what kind of text we are looking for, whether we want to make it bold, italics, or you know, there are different elements. This is a visual way to do it. The next way to do it is using the text. So if you're a developer, you know all the HTML elements, all the HTML tags that you want to write for your HTML, you can use this. But I would prefer to use this, and then if I need any custom modification that I cannot do in the visual view, I go into the text view and do it. But let's start doing it over here. We will write sample text 1, sample text 1. Okay, let's save this. Let's see how it reflects in the front end. You see the sample text 1 here. Now this section is not exactly what, you know, how we think it should be. Okay, so first let me quickly remove the section 3. It's creating a disturbance over here. remove the section 3, just delete it. Great, it's been removed. Now we see that on the demo page, you know, some things are overlapping, right? That sample text one is in lines with the arrow, the navigation arrow that we have for this carousel, and that's not what we want. So we will have to shift this entire section to the right hand side and you know, keep nice spacing between both the sections. So we are going to go ahead and do that now. Now if you notice, the right hand arrow is not working. Okay, the left section arrow is working. Now let's open the inspect element, right click on the page, click on inspect, select this inspect, select an element to inspect the page. Now if you see on the right hand section, the right hand section that we created, the 1x3, the arrow is hidden below this section, hence it is not clickable. So we have to modify this section a little bit, the left hand carousel section a little bit, to constrain the width of it, to you know, limit the space. So let's go ahead and do that. We will click on the tabs. Now we need to restrict this width for the entire tab section, not only for one tab section or not only for one carousel, because all your both the sections will have a blog carousel, right? So let's click on edit tabs. Okay, and we will change the, okay, sorry, not this. We will have to click on edit this column. Okay, because we are changing the setting for the entire column, as all the columns, this entire column, both the sections is going to have a block carousel section, as I said. So the content width is 100%. That means it's end to end, from the very left to the very right. Now we will limit it to 90% and check how this looks. If the arrow becomes functional, then we'll keep it to 90, or else we'll reduce it further. We'll close the inspect element. Great. So you see the right hand arrow is now moving, is now animating as well when I hover on it. So that means this 90% that we did worked out. All right. Now again, if you see, the left hand section is looking a little smaller than expected. Okay, and we do not need such a big right hand section. So we will again go ahead and change the column, the columns that we did before, that is 2x3 and 1x3. We are going to change the left hand section to 5x6 and 1x6. I think that's enough for us, because we are more focusing on the carousel. It has a lot of data that user should click on. So let's keep the section a little bigger than the right hand section, because the right hand section will only have text listed. Great, just click on it and it's beautifully done by the page builder. Now we will update this. We will again go back to the home page, refresh. Nice. Now this section is looking a lot better than what it was before. Okay, perfect. This is what we want. The arrows are working, left and right arrows are working. Now let's create the, now let's, you know, add more text to this. We will create, we will go here, we will edit the section. When you edit the section, you have an option of paragraph. Now this is a drop down, so you can edit the size of the text according to, you know, what options are here, or you can highlight it, create, make it bold, make it italics. Okay, I won't do anything, but I will just go ahead and change the font size from here. I need it as heading 3. Now below this I need a horizontal line. Okay, so let's see, where is this option? Is there a direct horizontal line option here? No, there is not. No problem. I'll show you how to do it. we have to make this sample text one, you know, very similar to the one that we see here in overdrive.in. So let's go ahead and start editing each and every line item which is available. Okay. So we created the columns as 5 by 6 plus 1 by 6. So that means this section is pretty small over here, and we need to increase the size of the text very carefully. Otherwise, if we increase it, you know, just randomly, it will go to the next line. One sentence is going to go to the next line. Okay. We will do one thing over here. We will reduce the size of the left hand side, okay, a little bit, so that, okay, one second. No, we'll keep it as is. We'll keep it as is. We just need to create or set the font size as required. Font size 12px. So now this means that beyond 18px we cannot go, okay, to for the font size. Now here it's a huge padding which is applied. We have to make sure that we remove this padding restriction of the box. Okay, let's go back here. We will edit this column. Okay, we are not going to edit. First, we are not going to edit each and every text box. We are going to edit the column. And what are we going to do here? We are going to remove the padding which is applied, padding or the margins which are applied on the left hand side, so that we have some more width to display the text. Okay. Now we see, let me show this to you again. Edit this column, okay? Once you are here, go to design options. You will see now a 50 pixel padding is applied for this box. That means this sample text, this four text which is there, the outer box. So we need to remove that 50 pixel limitation, and we need to make it zero, or you know, just make it blank and save it. Now we'll update it. Come back to the home page, refresh. We should see some more space available for the text now. Okay, so you see this horizontal line has extended towards the left, and now we can increase the size of the text and check how it looks. Now we can increase the size. Let's make it to heading 5, a little bigger than heading 6. Come here, refresh. Great. So now we see a text bigger than the previous one. Let's try one more time. Let's make it heading 4. Check if this is possible. If this works, then it will look very good. Refresh. No, it doesn't work. So we can keep it. We can keep it X heading 5, and we can make it left align. Yes, save it, update. Great. Now again, one more. One more try. We will make it heading 4. Save. Update. Let's see if it fits. No, it doesn't fit. Okay. Now, you know, just to give you an example of how this text works. Okay. Now we were using visual. Now let's go to text. So if you have some knowledge of HTML, you should be able to, work this out. instead of writing an H4 element, I'll write a div. Okay, this is basically a little bit of customization when things don't work out directly using the elements. Now I can give it a text size, a font size of, let's see what, font size 18 pixel, increase. Okay, so font size of 26 pixel is fitting properly in our requirement. So I will write font size 26 pixel, save, update. Let's see how it looks here now. Okay, it's not fitting in. 20. Okay, a font size of 21 is also looking good. We will change it to font size of 21. Now I'll show you what changed when I switched from the h tag header tag to the div tag. Now there is a color difference, font style difference, font size difference. Because we were using the header tag, it was giving us a white text with a different font, okay, and the size also differed. Now as we changed it to a div element, all the default settings that is there in the theme for the h tags has been removed, and we have got a different kind of text over here. Okay, so that is the difference. You need to be very careful when you use it. So you should be well versed with how HTML works and what are the tags. Okay, so we will apply the same setting for all the basically for all the four text which is available here. So I will copy this. I will go back to the editor, go to text, copy this, and we have to apply this for all the lines. Okay, change it to text. After applying the div and the custom HTML to all the line items, now all the sentences are looking similar. Now let's go ahead and apply proper margins and paddings to all the four line items. Let's go back to WP admin. Now again we'll have to write some custom HTML and also CSS to do this, but that is one option. The other option is we have an element that we can add over here. Let's see what element can be added. It's called an empty space, right? Blank space with custom height. So that's what we are looking for, right? After each sentence, there is a horizontal line. And after that, we need a space, just like what we see here. So there is a space, there is a space after the horizontal line, there is a space above the horizontal line. But now we are going to work on the space after the horizontal line. Let's add an empty space. Here the pixel would be 4. Save. We'll move this empty space below the first text and the first divider. Okay, after adding this first space, let's see how it looks, and then we will continue adding the same to the others. Okay, it added a lot of space to it. So we need to reduce the pixel that we added. Instead of 4 pixel, we will add just one. I think this should do the trick. Yeah, but still there is a lot of space and we do not need this much space. So let's edit it again. Let's see what all options it has. We have a custom space as well. So this is 32 pixel. Let's reduce it to 20 pixel. You saw, right? We selected custom and it gave us an option to add how many pixels we want to add over there. So now the space has reduced. I'll keep this as 20. I'll replicate this same thing and I'll keep on shifting it below each section. Again, replicate, shift it to the next section. And after the last section, we do not need any space, no horizontal line. So we are not going to duplicate it again. Let's refresh. Beautiful. So now the last thing that we need to do is add some space above the horizontal line. Okay, let's do that as well. In fact, you know what? Instead of doing anything else, we'll clone the empty space again, move it below the sample text, edit this thing. Now, as we have added 20, we just add 10 pixel to it. Okay, I think this should do it. Awesome. So this is the exact format that we were looking for and we were able to achieve it. Let me quickly replicate it for all the other line items and we should be done with that section. I'm cloning it again, moving it to the right place, clone again, move to the right place. Yep, and we are done. Refresh. Perfect. Perfect. So we were able to achieve section 1, section 2. We were able to add a carousel inside section 1, a carousel inside section 2. We were able to add a custom HTML CSS with the help of few elements on the right hand side. And now we are going to go to the next section. Our next section is all about how do we manipulate all the fonts, use the fonts, the styling, the animations that we are looking for. So one is font style, one is font size that we just, you know, saw how we do that. Then we are also going to work on some animation. So these three things is the next focus point. To customize the section in terms of fonts and font style, there is a different way that we need to approach it. We cannot do it directly from the WP Bakery page builder, but we also need to see what all fonts are available in the themes that you have purchased, okay, and that you have configured. So what we'll do first, we will go to the section where you have the theme options. Every theme that you have will always have a theme options section. Okay, so in this Rocale theme, we have the theme options here. I will go ahead and open the theme options. Okay, now you will see this section. You will first land on the home page, right? Home page for the Rocale theme. We will focus on the section that we recently created, that is the second fold, section 1, section 2, and the sample text 1. Okay. I'll rename the sample text 1 with sample text 2, sample text 3, and sample text 4 so that we don't get confused where we are right now when we are referring to it. So this is sample text 2, sample text 3, and sample text 4. To use custom fonts in WordPress, directly things are not available, but let's go ahead and add a plugin that will help us use custom fonts and give custom styling according to our needs. So we are going to use this plugin named Easy Google Fonts. Now Google Fonts has a lot of options. Okay, so we'll go ahead and install the Google Font plugin, Easy Google Font. We'll activate it. once it's activated, we'll go to the Google font, the easy Google fonts page, to see what all options is there and what all we need to configure. All right, great. So we have installed it now. What's new? Go to Google. If you scroll down, you'll see go to settings, easy Google fonts. Let's directly jump there. Now we have a lot of options over here. I mean, I can create a small tutorial of how this works and tell you what all configuration needs to be done to go ahead and use it. I already have this configuration, so I'll skip this step. And if you're looking for a demo, do leave a comment and I'll create a quick video on how to configure this. The plugin is successfully installed. Let's see. Let's hover on the settings menu and we have easy Google fonts here. So before we go into Google fonts, I want to tell you how the Google font will reflect on some element that we want to style. Okay. This is the backend editor, as you know. This is the first text block that is sample text one. If you go to the text area, as I have created an entire custom element using a div, I have given it a class name, and that class name is second fold text. Okay, this is a class name. Now don't worry guys, if you don't know what a class is basically something that uniquely identifies an element and applies a style to it. So as I've mentioned second fold text, for some other text you can also give a different class name and use this class name and apply a different style to a different text. Okay, so let's go ahead. Using this second fold text, I will apply custom style and custom font, custom colors to one of the text fields, to one of the text that we have added on the right hand side. Okay, let's close this. Now we will move on to the easy Google fonts. Okay, so now easy Google fonts gives us a lot of options. It helps you do color changes to your text. It helps you apply a custom font to your text. Okay, and many other things, but we will cover these two things, a font style change and a font color change. Okay, completely customized, and this is independent of the theme that you're using. I will create. So from the create section, okay, you need to create a font control name. Okay, I will give it the name as TA1. Now, what is the font control CSS selectors? CSS, as we just discussed, I have given a class name to an element. So a class is a CSS selector. Similarly, there is a concept of ID selectors as well. So an ID can be given to an element, that is ID is equal to something. And like, you know, in similar way, like we have defined the class. So we will use the same class name over here. Okay, I had copied that. I'll paste it over here. Now, a CSS selector is always defined by three things. Okay, it either has a dot. It is either prepended by a dot. That is, it starts with a dot. So now, if I put a dot in front of any text, that means it's a class name. Okay. If I add a hash in front of any name, that means it's a ID. Basically, it's a ID given to any element. Okay, so now we have defined a class. So I will go ahead with the dot. Once you put the dot and once you put the text name, you have to hit enter. So sorry guys, I did not mention about the third CSS selector. The first is the class, second is the ID, third CSS selector can be any element directly. So you remember that we have used div, right? We can use div, we can use p tags, we can use a tags. So there, like any HTML element available can be added over here as a CSS selector. But we use class names and IDs to be specific and to target only specific elements. It can be multiple, so multiple class names can be given to multiple elements. I mean, a single class name can be given to multiple elements so that you write style once and that style will be applied to multiple elements. ID is basically used to uniquely identify an element. So ID is always unique. You can apply it to only one element. Okay, so I have hit the enter button. Now you see that it's selected. I click on the create font control. Okay, TA1 has been created. Now we will quickly go ahead to the home page. Okay, so this is the home page that we are working on, right? And here we see that sample text 1, sample text 2, sample text 3, sample text 4. We are targeting sample text 1 for now. Now, once the Google font, easy Google font, we have created a font control. We go to the home page, we have to click on customize. Okay, now if you come on the front end, you will see this customize button in the header. Okay. Or there is one more option. You can go to the settings menu. I'm sorry. You can go to the appearance menu. Okay. In the WordPress backend. And you have to click on customize. But I will do the customize from here because it's directly on the home page. And the customization will start appearing for this specific page. Customize. Now we have a lot of options. We will discuss about, you know, a lot of options later, but for now we are targeting typography. Let's click on typography. There are two options: default typography, theme typography. So default typography comes default with WordPress installation and also with the theme that you have installed. So all the settings that you have, the theme will be available in the default typography. Now the theme typography is given to us by Easy Google Font plugin. So let's click on that. So now this is the font control that we have created, TA1. Now the beautiful thing over here is as soon as you apply a font, it will start reflecting on the right hand section and you can see a live change. Okay, you don't need to refresh the page to understand what's happening. So let me give it a unique font that is Annie, use your telescope. Now I have selected this based upon the uniqueness of the font so that you see the difference very specifically on the page. Let's select this. Wonderful. So you see how the text is reflecting. The font style has been changed. The font family has been changed. Now there are other options. You want to keep the font weight regular or theme default. You want to change the text decoration if you want to underline it. Line through, overline, doesn't make sense for now, so we'll keep it as none. Text transform. Now if you want this entire text to capitalize, you can select uppercase. If you wanted lowercase, all, you know, in small characters, all you need to capitalize it. Okay, so capitalize or none, it depends on, you know, what your preferences are right now. So this font settings are done. I'll go to style. So now we have a lot of presets over here, preset colors. This is the pink color, white color, blue color. I will select a color which matches our theme, that is the yellow color. Okay, you can also customize your color if you want some color that you are looking for. You can put a code over here from any external source, copy the code, paste it over here, or you can select any colors which are available on the page. Background color, I do not need any background color, so I will reset it. But yeah, you have an option to set a background color as well. Font size. font size is not reflecting over here. Maybe you know, there is a catch to it, but I'll explain it to you. I'll explain that later. Later, spacing. See how beautifully this is shown on the right hand side. Letter spacing. So I'll reset it. I do not want to change it right now because it looks perfect for our use. The position, I'll keep everything as is because it looks perfect. If you're satisfied with the results on the right hand side, go ahead and publish this. Now, as it is published, your font styling is done. Okay, now this looks so nice. You know, independent of the theme that you purchase, independent of WordPress that you're working on, this easy Google font plugin is so easy to use, and it helps you define your font styling uniquely in different sections. Maybe you want to highlight a section where people should concentrate on. So this plugin is going to help you do that. Okay, now let me show you the beauty of using classes. Now, you have done settings for one section, but now you do not want to do the same settings again and again for all the remaining three sections, right? So there is one easy trick to it. I'll go to our edit page, the backend editor of this homepage, all pages, home demo, edit this. This is the backend editor. Edit the first block that you just changed. Copy this class. Okay, copy this class. You see the highlighted text, right? Class is equal to second fold text. Copy this. Go to the next section. Edit the text block. Go to text. Define the class name over here. Just paste the class name over here. I'll do it for all the sections. Not all the sections. Let me show you the difference. I did it for the next two sections. Okay, next, the text, two text below the first one. I'll refresh. Wow. So now you see only copy pasting the class name is applying that style that you applied for the first text to the second and the third text as well. Okay, so if you do not want the same styling for all the text, you can apply or you can create different font control name and apply your own style for different text available. But as that is one section, I want to apply the same text format, the same size, the same color to all the text which is available. So I'm going to apply the same class to the last text. Update. Great. So with this, we are done with how to apply font style, colors, change the color for specific areas of your website, not for the entire website. There is a different procedure if you want to apply a font change or, you know, style change, font size change, color change to all the sections of the website. But we are not targeting that part right now because that is not in our requirement. So if you have any doubts regarding this, comment in the comment section and I will come up with an answer for you. Let's move on to our next section, that is animation. We can apply animation to pretty much everything on the website, but it should also make sense, guys. You know, just to beautify your website or applying animations throughout your website will not make sense to the user as well. You should apply animations to only those areas which user should focus on. Basically, it should be more attractive than any other section. For example, let's go on the home page. Now, I want people, when they look at this section, I want them to you know, get attracted to the right hand section, that is the sample text 1, sample text 2, or sample text 3, sample text 4, right? Out of this, I want, there is some new topic that has come up. Okay, for this is an example, new topic that has come up. So I want people to focus more on the sample text 4 area. Okay, so I will animate only this one. You can do it according to your requirement, but now I'm going to show you how you animate the sample text 4. We will also animate some other sections in the next sections that we are going to cover. Let's edit the block, text block, the fourth text block. There is a straight tab over here, animation. So the CSS animation is no right now. There are so many options. You can select each and every option and check how it looks. And if it is according to your requirement, select it and save it. Now the CSS animation delay. All right. So once the page is loaded, once the user comes in the second fold of the website, after how many seconds or milliseconds this text should appear using this animation that you have selected, feed in. Okay, so now I will say 100,000 milliseconds, that is 1 second. Okay, CSS animation, I want it to appear very slowly so that the user understands what's happening over there. I have updated it. Let's go back to the home page and see how it looks. Did you see the effect? I'll refresh it once again. So after 1000 milliseconds, the sample text 4 appeared. Very simple animation, right? There is no rocket science, or there is nothing that is hidden in CSS animation. Let's give it a nice animation that is zoom in so that it is more prominent. Refresh. Correct. So I can also, you know, increase the text size of this. Okay, so that it looks unique and different from the other three text which is above it. Let's do one thing. As I told you that we will also apply some more animations. We'll apply the animation to the banner that we have added over here. Okay. The test link banner on the top, that is of Overdrive. We will go here. Single image edit. Animation. Now we wanted to fade it from the left hand side, actually from the right hand side. Okay, so it will look like it is coming from the right hand side of the screen and getting set in the area which is allotted to this image. Now the CSS animation delay, I wanted as let's say 2000. The CSS animation duration should be very slow. Now, why I selected 2000? Because once the user is here, the user is, you know, looking at these sliders, the latest section, and suddenly this thing comes up from the right hand section. Because I want them to get divert their view towards this, because this is a very important banner for me. So let's save this update. Refresh. Now it's not there. Now I am doing something and suddenly I see it. So all my attention is driven towards this banner, right? So that's my target. That's what I wanted my user to, to get attracted to. And that is why I applied a more delayed animation. You can do it according to your requirement. You can also, you know, pull in this image from the right, left, top and bottom. You can also control the speed as we have seen. So this is pretty much about the animation. We will go through some more animations in the coming videos, in the coming sections. And this is it in the animation section for now.
If you have liked this video, give it a thumbs up, please. If you know someone that who want to learn WordPress and who is looking to build their own website or build websites for their client, do share it with them. And you can also hit the subscribe button so that I can keep coming up with more and more WP episodes, WordPress episodes, and you will get more and more knowledge from from me for WordPress. So we are also going to start a new episode, a new series of a different programming language soon. I'm creating a list of things that I need to do in that. So keep watching, keep sharing, keep liking, and thank you for giving so much love to me till now. And I believe that I can help more and more people every day. All right, thank you for watching this video. Keep watching. I'll be back soon. Thank you so much.